You're an imposter, sorry, Detective Buggy. Number two, would you tell us what your name is and what you do, please?
My name is Chris Hart, and my mother is the charming panelist, Kitty Carlisle.
Let's go down the line. Number three, now that we've had our fun, what is your real name, please, and what do you do?
My name is Joe Garagiola, Jr.
Something to me.
Hi.
Okay, here's what we're going to do. I've got one more question. I'm going to ask it. If it brings enough points, 43 points, and there are 200 points, we're going to dance up and down because you've got $10,000, but we're going to leave your sister off stage. And then we're going to reset that clock and bring her back out and make her think she needs to get 180 points. Our survey set. Everybody settle down. All right, just bring her this way. Don't let her look at the clock. It's not looking good, Glenda. There's a lot of number one answers there. Your partner only came up with 18 points. You need 182 points for the $10,000.
Okay.
You can do this. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck. There were three stooges named Curly's wife. Quickly. What was the name of Little Orphan Annie's dog? Quickly, give me a number between 3 and 5.
4.
Name something you do when you're angry.
Cry.
Name a handsome game show host.
You.
Okay, 10.5. Look quite your partner up.
Bert, earlier in the week you told us that you were half Indian. Would you please spell reservation?
I don't think that's funny, Tom.
I don't either.
I mean, are you calling me a name or something? Or?
No, sir.
Because if you are, I'm going to take your head off and spit it. No, they don't like that, Tom.
Remember the great Jack Collins did this?
Oh, we treat you well on this show. Stroganoff, dig in and enjoy. Alrighty, now let's meet the person who specializes in unusual dishes. I, Terry Arnell, maintain that meat prices are much too high. Fortunately, I've hit on an ingenious, money-saving, palate-pleasing plan. Take, for example, my glorious beef stroganoff, which the panel is eating now. Not only is the meat in my stroganoff healthy and delicious, but also very reasonable in price.
Get out of here. What is it?
Why?
What?
Because it's dog food.
Oh, God!
You're not gonna believe what we're gonna show you now.
In what way is your husband romantic? Assuming that he is.
Oh, man, have you ever been made love to by a Frenchman?
Not that I can recall.
Show. We have talented people like the Ramiro family on our show. Paul is a concert pianist. Steve, what do you do?
I sell frozen bull semen for artificial insemination.
All right, Steve. It's always nice talking to you. I'm sorry we don't have time for a demonstration.
Describe for Patty these things associated with yogurt.
It's got stuff that's good for your bones.
Calcium.
Uh-huh. And, it's...
Culture?
Eli, what's
What's the worst thing a player can do in your favorite sport?
Well, my favorite sport is playing basketball.
What's the worst thing a player can do?
I guess it will be a worst thing not to throw, you know, not to have my English, I'm telling you, it's a little bit hard. My Spanish is better.
Well, go ahead and tell me in Spanish.
I don't speak Spanish at all.
Oh. We asked 100 women, name something women borrow from each other. Chris.
One another's husbands.
Their husbands. You never know?
Never know.
You think that made the survey?
No.
I'm playing my...
Tambourine?
Yes. I take wrap rubber bands around my t-shirt and stick it in...
Tie-dye?
Yes. These are the ugly sandals that lesbians wear.
Birkenstocks.
Yes. Yes.
Veronica, I understand that at one time you wanted to become a mortician.
He made me quit. My husband.
Why?
Well, he didn't appreciate my sense of humor. I put an ear in his lunch one time because we got in an argument. And,
when we come back, you'll see what happens when everything, and I do mean everything, on a game show goes wrong. But first, you recognize this famous person? We'll tell you who it is when the most outrageous game show moments 3 returns. Welcome back to the most outrageous game show moments 3. Now, before the break, I ask you if you recognize this person. Did you figure out who it is? Let's see who some of the people here thought it was.
Gabe Kaplan from Welcome Back, Kotter.
I think this is James Garner from The Rockford File.
Wasn't he the teacher on Room 222?
He looks like somebody that played off Planet of the Apes.
He looked like Bob Marley to me with a clip of dreadlocks.
Looks like my father. But...
Now, they were way off base. Do you know who this is? Believe it or not, this is a photo of a very young Alex Trebek, better known as the host of Jeopardy. You know, every now and then something happens that throws a perfectly good game show completely off course. Suddenly the rules are tossed out and the game takes on a strange life of its own. Here's a few perfect examples of when good games go bad.
A specific food with an edible skin.
A banana.
Oh!
What's wrong with that?
What's wrong with it? We got a banana here. Which one would you like?
I'll take this one.
All right, here we go. Spit it out after I'm half dead here.
Beth, you have to. I did it.
Here
you want
are.
To show me how?
Show you how?
Be our guest.
Oh, good.
Why don't you hold it? Take her off. Take her off.
Play this time we're back with Dick.
Oh!
Are you all right? No, don't be good. What happened was she fell in my hole. You see?
And now Barbara, she's trying to get her hands on some of that bonus item as well. Hurry up, Paul, hurry up. We're running out of time, shoppers. The countdown's underway. Here comes Michelle. Watch out!
Dumb Dora is so dumb.
How dumb is she?
I'd
tell you how dumb she is. She sent her cultured pearls to blank.
School.
School.
Or even a state university, college.
State university? What did you get, Beverly?
Finishing school.
Finishing school is another math. That's four for him.
School finishing.
School of finishing.
What?
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
School. Now wait just a second. Will everybody just shut up for a second?
Telling me the word college is
college?
Better than school?
School?
Hold everything
oh,
now.
No, wait.
No, I'm
Please
sorry.
No, I'm not sorry.
Would you show us your answer, my dear?
I'm afraid.
Got you, sir.
Show the answer, hon.
Night school.
Night school.
Tonight's most outrageous game show moment has got to be Gilbert Gottfried one night on Hollywood Squares. Now, let me set the scene for you. Every square had an X or an O except for Gilbert's. All the contestant had to do to win the game was to correctly agree or disagree with Gilbert's answer. Sounds easy, right? Not on that night.
Welcome back to maybe the longest first $1,000 game we've ever had.
Gilbert Gottfried.
Gilbert Gottfried! Okay! Square win. Gilbert, Playgirl Magazine's clinical sexologist, says, I think we should be able to talk about sex the way we talk about what?
I'm going to say food.
I'll disagree.
Food. All right. Now, Valerie,
where are you going?
Gilbert Gottfried
wow,
for the win.
Surprise. Okay. Gilbert, in a poll, 94% of Hungarians, compared to only 46% of Americans, said doing this was necessary to feel fulfilled.
Having a child.
I disagree.
You fool!
Having a child is correct,
oh,
David.
Gilbert Gottfried.
When she heard that Phileas Fogg had done it in 80 days, journalist Nellie Bly beat him by doing it in 72 days. What did she do?
This is rowing the Atlantic.
I'm gonna agree.
You fool!
Gilbert Gottfried.
The tube top.
I agree.
You fool! It's the last perfect pitch game.
I'm gonna agree.
You fool!
Oh!
Valerie, your turn.
Gilbert Gottfried for the yeah. win.
The Crusher.
I'll agree.
You fool!
All right, Officer Dave.
Gilbert Gottfried for the win.
Gilbert Gottfried for the win. The word smog comes from what two words?
Smoke and fog.
Smoke and fog.
I'm gonna agree.
Smoke and fog!
That's the end of our show, everybody. Thanks for playing. I'm Bob Eubanks, and we'll see you next time on the most outrageous game show moments. Good night.